Yeah, no, it was stopped. The video was stopped. Damn it. Sorry, guys. I guess I was playing music that was not monetized. I think it's what they call it. Dang it, I lost Miss Charms. Hello again, yes. I know. Josh is here. Josh, welcome back, guys. Sorry about that. I was playing music, and I guess I got demonetized. But whatever. So we'll wait like 3 minutes. Wait! Dude, you're here. You snuck in on me. How'd you do that? I missed you. Our conversation last week got interrupted. So wait a couple minutes while we're waiting for a few more people to join. Keep wanting to tap the screen. I think you can, you know, I'm not sure. But all that money rolling. What do you know that I don't, Ari? I wish. Go over a few things real quick. It has been a busy week for everybody. Grizz has been sending me messages about Lion's Gate. Maybe if Ari or Josh or Kelly can maybe talk about that for a little bit, that might be great. I still don't understand it, but I know it's affecting people's energies really bad. It's been a rough week for me energetically, and I just, everything just kind of came to head this afternoon. But I'm glad everybody's here. Mostly family is here today. An alignment of planets? I still don't know what, I guess so. Lionsgate just ended, okay? It's Leo season? Yeah, it's actually Leo season. You can talk about it? Maybe. So other than that, hope everybody's Friday went well. Are in line with your birth planets? Wow. That's pretty cool. Leo Sun, Aquarius Moon Baby. Full Moon mainly. Okay. August 12th, peak energy on the 8th? Yeah. We were supposed to have an artist, a guest tonight. We kind of planned it out all week. Unfortunately, she won't be able to show up tonight. Just before we were ready to go on, she had an emergency. So I had asked her to take care of that instead and reschedule for her maybe next week. We'll see how things go. But there was something that she needed to give her full attention to tonight, and I didn't want for that to for tonight be a hindrance for her and her family. So instead, we're going to go with Plan B. But actually, no, don't give me this. Really? Yeah, it was meant to be. But I'm glad you guys are here. Our community is growing. We're getting the word out. If you guys haven't yet, Grizz started a new account. Jade Tiger, I believe, is her new account on Instagram. So if you guys haven't already, I think most of you have. Wade, I don't think you have, but you're welcome to join the new tribe she started, chat. That's up to you. But it is, yep, Ari, you can call in. You can go ahead and call in. Anyway, her new Instagram, which will be dedicated just to spiritual type work that she wants to do, is Jade Tiger. So go ahead and give that a follow if you haven't already. Yep. Jade_Tiger. Jade_Tiger. So at the beginning of Fridays, what I had asked Ari to do is to lead us in meditation for a few minutes. I thought it would be a good way to really bring down the energy in the room and just make everything just balanced energetically. So I know Ari's got some experience in that, and I had asked her to do that for us. So there she's calling in. Okay. Yes. Right. She's on.
From Lend from Kelly. Thank you. It's me. Hey, Ari.
Hey. How's it going?
Good. You combed your hair. You didn't leave it up in the bun?
No, like Jufro bun business. Went on to.
Gotcha.
I did choose not to fall asleep. Not dead.
Let's get. Hey, I wore a new shirt, so you know.
Oh, great. Ready for that official lock?
I think we're all good. Yep. Exactly. So at this point, Ari,
okay,
it's totally up to you. You have this.
Oh gosh, that's a lot. I'm kidding. Yeah, so I figured what I would do is just maybe like lead you guys through what I do for a meditation. I like try to kind of talk myself out through it. I'm personally a very visual person. Like if you go into the clair senses, I tend to be more clair, like I picture stuff in my head, but I was also going to try to like cater it to like also feeling yourself in your body, because I know like not everybody can picture things in their mind. So anyone who would like to meditate, I recommend sitting with your feet grounded on the floor and just letting your face soften or closing your eyes. And I like picture roots going from my feet into the ground and picturing feeling the connection between my heels and my big toes, and just seeing in my head as if I am rooted into the ground. And I begin to bring your gaze inward and focus on your breath, feeling the ground under your feet, and slow your breath. Notice what it feels like. Watch it stop. Ground feels like within stock. And feel energy from the ground and from the earth move up your shins as you focus into your breath. And if your mind wanders, that's okay. Notice your mind wandering and bring your gaze back to your breath. It's all part of the process. And I feel the energy move up in your face, taking breath. I want you to yourself back to the people. Picture the energy moving up your legs, feeling the connection still with the ground. If you're seated, feel yourself connected with the earth and your chair connected to the ground. And picture just feeling like, feel it coming up from the earth, moving up your body, taking a deep breath in, holding it, and releasing it. Back to the people. Now feel the energy moving up your stomach. And any negative feelings in your abdomen, releasing your breath. As you breathe in, imagine yourself bringing the energy of the best people, bringing the negativity, the bad energy, what's not yours. Feel energy travel from your breath up your spine, Feel like crawling up, breathing in people, and really what's not for. Going to your shoulder, feeling knots in your body, and release. Breathe in the best people. Going down your arms, and release. Picture the color. You attract the best. Now the energy climbs up your and release with all the tension of the day. And breathe. Feeling the energy relaxing your shoulders, relaxing your arms, falling into your jaw. Take a deep breath in. I attract the people. The energy climbs up your face and through your crown. And you release what it's not for. As you breathe in the energy around your head, picture it encircling your body. Anything not for. Taking earth. Hold it. Bring your gaze. You attract the best people. Slowly take your arms. Bring your breath. You attract the people. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes.
Wow, that was awesome.
That was it.
That was awesome, Ari. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That was fantastic. I could actually feel like my chakras being energized one by one by one by one. That was awesome. I needed that.
I didn't think about how to end that. Sorry.
It's totally fine. You did exactly perfect. Thank you so much, Ari. I really appreciate you doing that. I look forward to you doing it every week. It was just amazing.
Cool. Thanks. I'll try to.
Welcome. Well, it's interesting to see how others meditate. Very similar to how I meditate, but I use a lot of guided meditation too, so it does help. See, Josh said you get goosebumps in the middle.
Hey, thank you.
So did I.
I hope that wasn't rushed.
No, it was perfect. I could feel the energy rising up because all of a sudden I got all these, we call it chills.
Mm-hmm.
It was awesome. I needed that, especially after the kind of day I had today. It was just kind of junky today.
I realize, like, we forget to release all the crap that, like, when you go through your day, you interact with people, and everybody brings in their own energy, and a lot of people can get very, like, thank you, Kelly, very, like, stuck in the negative, and they put that on you, and you take it in, and even when you're trying to help somebody, you share their energy, and so it's really good to just cleanse that.
Yeah, sometimes, I'll be honest, sometimes I forget to do that, and I sit in that negativity for the night, and it eats at me until I get up in the morning, and then I remember, you know what, that's not my energy. I don't need it. Get rid of it. Send it back to where it came from, but that was just perfect. I really look forward to doing that every week, because that was different for me.
It's rabbit approved.
Hey!
He's relaxed.
Hey, that was good because he made his little debut again.
Yeah.
On a Friday night.
He's very happy.
That was awesome. So, Ari, you know you are always welcome to stick around. I know you have other things going on. Let me pose this question. I don't know how you feel. I don't know how Kelly feels, but it would be kind of cool if both of you came on at once and did a reading.
I'll let Kelly
I don't know if it works like that. I'm curious if you both would do a reading for somebody, anybody. If you need a guinea pig, I'll be the guinea pig. I'm an open book. If you follow my... Go ahead.
I'll let her take the lead. I tried to do a reading on myself.
If you follow my Instagram and you see it every day, I'm an open book. I don't hide anything anymore. That's how I am. That's who I am.
Oh, hello.
Hey, let's let Jesus take the wheel tonight. Let's all be in here.
Wish.
Why do you have to bring him into the conversation?
Okay, I don't know why, but sometime earlier this week, I was in like just an idiot mood or whatever, and I was thinking, Jesus, take my bike, because my car's a piece of shit. Yeah, sorry.
Oh yeah, I hear you. I hear you.
I feel like Jesus needs to take my bike. Okay.
Now you want him to bring you a new car, that's what you want.
Yeah, but I don't trust myself with new things.
All right, so Kelly, did you hear what I asked Ari?
Yeah, I'm totally cool with Ari being in here. Absolutely, 100%.
Okay, cool. I know she had other things to go, so if she needs to go, Ari, you just let us know.
We're all good. I just, I'm visiting my mom, and I wasn't sure if they were going to stay up and, like, watch a movie, but she already went to bed, so it's cool. I'm going home tomorrow, but I've been here for a month anyway, so.
Okay, cool. All right, Kelly, you got the floor. Before we start, can I say one thing?
Yeah.
There was a young lady that joined Layla, the healer. Mm-hmm. I've been communicating with her, and I really would like for her to come on and do a presentation of the type of work that she does. And maybe in the near future, she will. So I asked her to come join and see what we're about. Her name is Layla.
Okay.
I know what she's doing. It looks like she's doing. Mm-hmm.
I think she joined. Yep. I think so.
I saw her join Layla the healer. Okay, Kelly, the floor is yours.
Okay, all right. So this Aquarius full moon is going to come with kind of a, I don't know why. That's weird. I heard rapture in my head. I don't know why I heard that. Anyways, Aquarius energy is always, if we're looking at it in evolutionary astrology, we're looking at the rebel of the system, right? So there's been a system in place. And in 2020, this whole plan was implemented where we were like, oh my God, what are we going to do? And we felt kind of the rumbling of our structures and everything kind of being halted, right? And us going into madness and descending into that madness and trying to find our authentic selves outside of that madness. The issue is that we thought that after we made that dramatic fall or we made that dramatic change that our life was going to instantly get better. We thought our life, you know, we thought things were going to be scrumdiddlyumptious. No, Daddy Saturn was like, absolutely not. We're not going for that. You still need to learn how to trust me. You still need to learn how to manifest. You still need to learn how to transmute your energy. You still got to learn all this. So in the full moon in Aquarius, we were figuring out our own structure around that time. Now, Promethean energy is adding something in that's never been done before because Prometheus was punished because he brought fire to humans, to the people, right? He was punished for bringing something new that the humans didn't know and evolved them at a very rapid pace after he brought what he brought in. So with that energy, it's like we're implementing something new and we really want this thing to work and spirit really wants this thing to work, but there's still a few kinks that need to be worked out and perspectives that need to be changed. And so it's about letting go of what perception we have of how we're going to make it or how this thing is going to go. And it's how much can you trust and surrender into this anxiety of you not knowing how this thing is going to end up working out. So it's basically all about trusting and surrendering and knowing we don't know exactly how this is all going to pan out, but we know that we can surrender and trust that whatever needs to happen is going to happen and that we're armed with what we need after these 2 years. So it's not really necessarily about like letting go of the typical Aquarian thing. It's more about letting go to divine timing and what's going on, because Aquarius is a direct connection to the divine. Aquarius is the first sign in evolutionary astrology that is representation of being outside of the physical body. So it's more about learning how to surrender and trust to the divine and how to not be so codependent on other people. That was very a Piscean energy, and entering into this Aquarian age, we're starting to get an understanding of what we're going to be dealing with for around the next 20 years in this Aquarian energy, how this interdependence plays out. And a lot of us could have had interruptions in our daily life, depending on wherever it is at in your chart, where it was like, maybe it wasn't a massive tower moment. For some of you, it could have been, because Uranus is very shocking. Uranus is very revelation wise, how are we going to think about these things? But it's more about what are we going to do in the future? How is the future going to pan out? This one isn't so much about the past. The only relevant parts about the past in this full moon, I mean, there is a lot, but is 2020 and how that plan started to formate. What belief system did we step out of in 2020? And what are we trying to formulate? And we're starting to get a good idea. And unfortunately, we get a good idea out of standing up for ourselves. We get a good idea when we set boundaries with someone and then we have to show up and actually be our authentic selves. We get a good idea of where this plan is going by the scary shit, the shit that we don't want to face, the shit that is so harrowing to us. That it feels like it's insurmountable. And so this is about letting go, trusting what the divine has for us, trusting the greater plan, and trusting that you're going to find where you fit, because Aquarius is also friend groups, community, bringing people together, healing, but not just healing from one person. Notice the theme here. It's healing from multiple people, healing and bringing out people's gifts and understandings of that, and just feeling like you're in the inner workings. And whatever project we're working on right now really isn't going to pan out until the next 3 months. We're really not going to get a good idea of like, yes, let's go, let's do this. That's going to come in about 3 months. We're going to have to surrender into what is right now. But a lot of those shocking revelations or that sharp energy you were feeling this week or those sharp turns that were happening aren't really going to be as, what's the word I'm looking for, piercing next week.
So let me stop you right there. You said three things that for everyone to know and to understand, and those are the three things that I have the most difficult time with: trust, letting go, and being patient. But you already knew that.
You're doing an amazing job. You really are. And it's incredible the obstacles that we're surmounting. Like, this is going to be more of an energy of, we're going to see the relevance of this in about 5 to 10 years. Like, let's say we build a massive community, or let's say someone comes into a bunch of money and then all of a sudden we get a bunch of farmland and we all want to live together and create this community, right? That's the kind of stuff we're going to be looking back on and being like, you remember when we were on Instagram and this was just kind of a, this is one of those moments where it's like, we have to kind of staple it to our calendars. But we're not going to really experience the relevance of it for some time.
No, I like it. I mean, even the part about a community coming together to do healing, which is what this is all about, what we are trying to create here. Yeah. It's not just a me thing, and I tell the moderators that all the time. It's not just about me anymore. It's about this community that I am really passionate about building, and if it means that I have to do some extra work, I have to give some extra energy to it, I will, because I think it's something that is needed. For one, people are always going to be looking for help. People are always going to be looking for answers. And if we can help point them in the right direction to do that, then we should.
You know what's a channeled song I've been hearing for this time, and I don't know why? Tears for Fears, Head Over Heels. I've heard that song so many times.
Okay.
So I think that's a channeled that's a channeled song for the energy of this full moon. But a lot of like the jaggedy stuff that you were talking about wasn't so much the Lionsgate. And what I do want to talk about with the Lionsgate really quickly is be careful where you're putting your energy or where you're harvesting your energy into, because people from government perspectives help like kind of can trap the energy. So just be careful with that, because a lot of people are like manifesting for purposes or for materialistic purposes, and sometimes that energy isn't harnessed for good. I don't know really how to describe that any other way. But Lionsgate is more of like an opening, and Lionsgate being on top of this full moon with the Leo Aquarius access, because Leo is self-consciousness. Leo is how are we perceived by the outside world and being very conscious of us. Aquarius is like the separateness. It's bringing people together. It's systems or reformated systems, rebels of, if you will. So it's like with this energy combined, it wouldn't be surprising if something completely shocking happened where it came to an end, like almost to the point of death for some people, or sickness, depending on where Aquarius is in your chart. It's very drastic. I kept seeing in this last week, the 23rd degree, and Nicholas, this isn't my thing with astrology, but it's degree theory, and each degree stands for something. I kept seeing the 23rd degree, which stands for separation, technology, things of that nature. So we could be getting like either dips in technology or understandings of where we can put our finances into a new stock or a new way of revenue, like revenue or finding money. Things that it's almost like the energy of like our plan. You get solutions to your plan, but it's not a closure, or it's not completely satisfying. It's still very an elusive thing in front of you that you're like, can I just figure out what the hell it is? I just want to put it in this box. And Aquarius is like, ha ha ha, there is no boxes, you know, that kind of feeling. Because Prometheus was known to be a trickster. Prometheus was known to be very much like, illusions and fantasy and being very funny. If anybody's seen, oh my gosh, it's on Disney, Loki. It's the same kind of energy as Loki. Prometheus is a little bit different, but yeah. Hey, Clayton.
Kind of like almost like a jester or like a trickster, like how Loki is.
Or like Heyoka. If like Native American terms, Heyokas. Heyokas are kind of the same thing. It's like they're there to change the energy or change the tone of the room. Master manifestors.
I believe Ari knew you were going to say Heyoka. And you know what? Right at that moment, I was thinking, I bet Ari knows what Heyoka is.
Loki? Yeah.
Okay. I thought you meant Heyoka. I swear I heard her say she has Native American.
Wait, what? Me?
Yeah.
Nah.
Did I hear that wrong?
like Eastern European Jewish, and then maybe that's it. It's all white. But actually, I took like a Norse a Viking samurai anthropology class, and so I don't know why, but
that's freaking cool,
right? That was like one of my first. classes in college was that, and like canoeing, which was my PE class. So, you know, got that like weird Aquarius, you know. But so I remember we learned a lot about like the trickster god. I really like how like Loki's very much like not bad, but he's not necessarily good. He's just like, keeping it fresh, I guess.
He's the balance. Okay, so Loki, when I was watching Disney Plus. Oh my God. Okay. First off, Owen Wilson in that show, in that series, is freaking great. But Loki was the one that made me start to think about, because for some reason in 2021, it was like, bad is not good. good is not bad. And it's almost like I have psychic Tourette's where I just think about this one sentence that doesn't necessarily make sense over and over again. And it started to make me realize that there's a divine balance. Like there has to be bad in order for there to be good. It's and like so that's what Loki's willing to do is like, he's indifferent. He doesn't care. Like if somebody has a penance that needs to be paid, he'll pay it. But if you have a contract with him, he'll kind of mess with you. Like I don't know enough to like go off on a tangent about it, but yeah. Am I messing you up?
No. I don't know. I read a little bit of like a lot of like novels about Norse mythology, that kind of stuff. And Loki, a lot of perspectives, I think it's just that he is very much like, I feel like, you know, if you know like science, pretty nerdy, but like Schrodinger's cat is like the idea that something exists and doesn't exist at the same time. And that's kind of Loki. And like, when you like oversimplify Loki, it's like that he's like this mischievous guy, he's always evil, but like I think the idea of Loki is like when you look at the villain, like Wicked, when you look at the villains from their perspective, you know, where it's like, oh, like this person's just acting on their own like drama, you know, their own melodrama, you know, they're just, it's not bad, it's not good, they're just doing what they're supposed to do, you know, and
yeah,
being and not being at the same time, you know.
Well, it's like people, I see a lot of people give crap to manifestation coaches, you know, and for some reason it really pissed me off and I never knew why. I was like, why is it pissing me off that they're being called out? And I didn't understand. And I guess my feeling on it, and this is probably going to piss people off if I were to say it in the masses, but is, yes, there's going to be manifestation coaches. Yes, there are going to be people that are off their way, or they're not doing it the proper way, or they have to learn a bit about colonization. So they get stuck in this manifestation trap. And then at the end of the day, they have this massive lesson and they start to help the native lands, whatever the hell it is. These people are misdirected for a reason. Mm-hmm. So when you're calling people out and you're spending entire videos just calling people out about how they're wrong, it's a waste of time.
Yeah. But like, people aren't misdirected. Like, you know, growing up Jewish, like something that always really bothered me was just like, you know, that there's people out there that believe that I'm going to hell because I don't think like them. And all paths to God are paths to God, you know? And so like everybody's path, it's not misdirection. And it might feel wrong in the moment, but it's their path and it's what's probably right for them, you know?
Exactly.
It's unfortunate because society has a certain way of view of how things should be done. And if you're not following that norm and you're outside of the box, then you're not the norm. Mm-hmm. And that's how society is, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's within your own family. Like my parents. Mm-hmm. They're like, you know, you need to go to church more. You know, I don't see you reading your Bible anymore. And what are you writing every morning? How come you write so long every morning? And well, Dad, I'm taking a different path. This is not your journey, it's my journey.
Yep.
So it's kind of the same with everything else, our spiritual life.
You know,
that's just my thought.
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. I got excited.
No, you're fine. Don't worry about it.
That I see is that we've all been sitting alone thinking that we're the weirdos, but then somebody's like gotten brave enough to be like, hey, like I'm weird, and then everybody else is like, wait, you're weird too, like I'm weird too, and we're realizing that like this, like, oh, we're breaking the norm. No, everybody else is like, we're all kind of weird, but we're getting brave enough to admit it. And I feel like I've been watching this one person who talks about like helping other people discover like their mediumship or their clairsenses. And it, like, I think a lot of people have clairsenses, but we're all sitting here thinking like, oh, I'm weird for this. Like, this is something special. And it's like, well, you might, more people got it than you know?
Yeah.
I've gotten to the point where I don't have patience. I don't have patience for people anymore. I don't know. Maybe I've been live streaming for too long. I have no idea, but I don't have patience for ignorance.
Yeah.
Like that. I don't anymore. I'm like, you know what, man? If I can sit here and listen to your rhetoric without judging you, even though it's semi-racist, because I know where the root is coming from, I'm not going to be pissed off. And I know that there's a nugget of wisdom in you. But the second I open my mouth about anything progressive or new age, you automatically think I'm a leftist or a Trumper or an anti-vaxxer or whatever the hell. It's like, I don't know. My boundaries have gotten so clear with that since 2020. It's like, I don't even try to flip their view or change their opinion anymore. It's not relevant. I want it to get to a point where it's just not relevant anymore. Like, I deal with it every so often, but it's not really relevant in my world. And that means that it might take a while in my actual physical reality for those people to show up. But
I feel like
I'm just so tired of compromising my energy.
Tell me what you think. This is what I'm hearing as you're speaking. Since 2020, you've become a lot more knowledgeable in many things in the path that you want to take, right, Kelly?
Mm-hmm.
And I believe at some point you had that little buffer, which was Wade and Anthony and myself and a lot of the other people that were in Periscope with you. So there was that buffer from all that negative energy that was coming into your room, and we tried to expel that out so you could do what you needed to do. But as you become more informed, as you become more educated, as you become more knowledgeable, the attacks are going to get greater.
I'm a dick, Luca. I'm a dick on TikTok. I'm a straight up dick. Like, if somebody, I had somebody come into my room, and you remember that guy? God love him. God, I loved him. I hope he's okay. But he was on Periscope, and he was like, he thought he was a god, or he was talking about being a god or some shit like that. I shut that shit down so fast on TikTok, his head spun. I was like, you know what? You know what happens to somebody, a people pleaser who finally gets their self-esteem? And the guy was like, what? I'm like, a god complex. Get the hell out of my room. I don't want it. Like, I literally don't. I feel like the pendulum is swinging right now. Like, every time I try to initiate something new in my life, like when I got sober and I had to speak my voice more because I really was like basically mute at that point. I would never state my opinion. I would never state my needs, nothing like that. And then when I started to state my needs, like, it came out really harsh, you know, it came out really like, I don't want to do that. You know, whereas like normally I'm like, okay, you know, we'll go. It's all right. And now it's formed into less of like a, I feel like it's an attack on me, and more of like a, I'm at 20% right now. Like, yeah, you can have 20% me, or we can wait a few hours and you can get 100% me, you know, or like, I already took my shoes off today, so we're not doing anything, right? You know, or just knowing myself. And but that pendulum has to swing. It has to swing from each side. And so I'm on TikTok right now at that part where I still feel like I sound like kind of a dick, you know, but at the same time, I'd rather have it swing this way and learn the lessons of this way too, so that I know where it's coming from both angles and I can help people from both angles. It's like, I'd rather let myself fully slide into the oblivion and just go for it than sit back and ponder what could happen or try to be perfect, because that's exactly what held me back. You know, that's what holds all of us back.
I mean, you got so much going on in a TikTok live. You have so many random people. And I feel like it's a very special case where, like, I don't know, because that's kind of the way, like, you, when you, like, we talked about this other day about, like, when you are.
We did.
Yeah, about, like, how you kind of go into a little bit of, a, like, an altered consciousness. And, like, I feel like the energies are very permeable. And so when you have a TikTok, somebody's on their phone and they're just sliding through stuff.
Yeah.
It land on your face, and so it's just like you're just like popping off all this energy, and someone just pops in, and it could be anyone, and they just bring whatever crap, and it is like almost like a little bit of an assault. And so like you got like, I don't know, it kind of reminds me of like when I'm like having like, you know, I have ADHD too, and like sometimes there'll be a thing like I can't, like my mom will call me on her hearing aids and her hair will start brushing on the hearing aid, or she's chewing, or she's just, or she starts washing dishes, and the background noise, it's I can't focus on what she's saying, and I'll be really short with her and be like, are you washing dishes? You need to stop. And then it's like,
yep.
I'm being a jerk right now, but it's just like that thing is so like, it's so like irritating and in your face that you're like, oh, this is a need that I need to have met right now. And like, I need like your energy to stop because it's not what's welcome here. Or like, I need that sound. I need that dishwater off.
I was a dick. This
you deserve
person
it.
That was a light worker or whatever came into my life today and was like, you need to tone down your energy. I was like, as a light worker, you're saying that to another.
Electric.
You're coming into my life and saying that. Do you really want me to, like, today is not the day.
You show up today? Tell you to turn it off, please.
Yeah.
She was like the She-Hulk. You wouldn't like her when she's angry.
Yeah. Sun's getting real low, buddy.
So let me say this. Let me say this to you, Kelly. Leave that big dick energy over in TikTok all the way over there.
Okay.
Because there is so much more that is here for you that's open. And I actually love being able to work with you again, even if it's only once a week or once every 2 weeks. I've missed working with you. I've missed seeing your face. I've missed hearing your jokes. If you want to be a dick on your time, it's fine. I know there's a lot more people who will be coming in to discover what Ari has to bring, what Kelly has to bring, what Grizz has to bring, and Josh, and Cran, and everybody else that gets involved in this community. Because it's not going to be Lucas Live for long. I'm going to be changing that. This is actually going to be a community line. I'm trying to work on putting a business account together, changing this account to business, so that any one of us can host a line. We can do it. Kelly can host it. Ari can host it. Anybody can host it. So I've been working on trying to get this account changed over to business.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Do that. All of us who wants to join and has something to offer, which we all do, all 7 of us in this room and all 15 who joined over the last 45 minutes, we have something to bring to the table. Yeah. And it's about time we take that ship, put it out in the open in the community and say, this is what I have to bring to the potluck, to the spiritual potluck. This is what I have. Show me what you have. If we can do trade, let's do a trade. If I can show you something new, let's do that. If I can help you remember how special you truly are and how grateful I am for what you've done and what you're doing now, this is the place that we want to do it at.
Same to you. Same to you.
Call us spear fingers. Miss V, I know you asked to join a little bit earlier. I wanted to hold off a little bit. I wanted to give Kelly some time and I wanted to give Ari some time.
Okay.
To kind of discuss a little bit what we were talking about, but Kelly.
Okay. So what I was going to say was, if I'm allowed, I wanted to do a 2-card pick a pile for whatever's happening this new moon. Or not Newman, Fullman, my bad. And then I have a client super early in the morning, so I'm going to have to trail off there after that. If that's okay, I might stick around for a little bit after that, but it's 10:30 here. So.
Yeah. Do you want me to get back?
No. Stay. Sorry, stay.
Okay.
Stay.
Hey, though, I'm forever. But it's rabbit right now. They're like, he's acting quiet, but he keeps like jumping around and doing.
Oh. Bowie's good. Bowie's already all right with me. Okay. So pick a pile in your mind of 1 and 2. I'm going to do a message for the pile. Let me get a connection really quick. Creating the universe. Holy Spirit, please help to guide me, give the best messages for those that are listening. What messages do they need to know for their highest good? Please only help me connect with healed ancestors, guides and angels. Clear, accurate, concise messages for pile one. A lot of you guys in pile one are getting your passion back. With the Hermit reversed and the Six of Cups reversed, you've possibly been in a place of isolation. And with the Seven of Swords, this is talking about something getting taken from you or some kind of betrayal happening or someone lying or walking away with something that you had. This could have happened quite some time ago. And so what's going on is you're getting your passion back with the Ace of Wands, or you're getting better ideas, like I was saying, for the new moon. And you're not going to be in such a place of lack, or you're figuring out where that place of lack is coming from. I feel like a lot of you in this pile are also understanding that you can be your own worst enemy when it comes to boundaries towards other people and trust issues. And trying to do the hard work it takes to actually get intimate with people and to actually be in the relationship and feel like you're working on relationships with other people. This could definitely be relationships too. Like, it feels like you're doing the hard work it takes to step back out into society is really what it feels like. Like with an open heart and wanting to see friends. And it might make you feel uncomfortable because there's such a change that's happened, but it's almost like rebuilding what was. And opening up about how you, if you are in a relationship with somebody, you could be opening up to them about how things feel a little bit lackluster, or understanding where the frustration is coming from. Grounding yourself will be really important. Let me see. Pile one. What does pile one need to know? With the full moon in Aquarius. What does pile one need to know? Yes. And a lot of you guys could be feeling, a lot of you guys are really getting to the nitty gritty of your shadows and figuring out what harmony means to you exactly. So it's like, now that you don't really have the processing of the white picket fence and the 2.5 kids or whatever you were being told, you're trying to figure out what authenticity means to you. Some of you guys could be releasing yourselves from certain family members that are toxic and realizing why. But with the High Priestess, you understand. You're coming into an understanding and coming into an ending. Letting go of the negative. You're getting clarity on why things haven't changed and why it's been such an upheaval. Like after the Tower. After the initial moment of shock, a lot of you guys are getting clarity on why the fights happened or why it needed to be, why it took such a long time. And you're also getting clarity on emotional fulfillment and what makes you happy. I feel for some reason I'm getting the message that a lot of you need to listen to your body. What I mean by that is, like, say you're mindlessly scrolling through social media or something like that. If your body is saying, I want food, or if your body is saying, I want to go out for a walk or whatever, that listen to your body, because listening to your body, this is going to sound kind of weird. Stick with me here. But listening to your body is going to help you trust yourself. Once you start to trust yourself more, it's going to be a lot easier for you to bring new people in and to trust whatever their intention is. And most importantly, trust your discernment in whatever their intention will be, knowing that you have your own back. It's like a lot of us feel like you have felt like you're traversing backwards and you haven't made that much effort, or with every step you've made, it's been 5 steps back. you're understanding why that's going on innately and understanding that the trust needed to lie within yourself the entire time and how you can do that practically. Also, I think that you guys are going to be getting tips on how to heal and soothe your nervous system so that you're not in that fight or flight or you're in fight or flight less, or you know how to kind of remedy that really bad if you're having a bad day.
Whew. Why are you looking at me? Why do I feel like you're looking at me when you're saying that shit?
No, I swear. I swear I wasn't looking at you. I wasn't.
Yeah, I swear. I didn't even know you picked one.
I didn't even know you picked one.
I picked file number two.
You did. Okay. Okay.
Can I have what's behind the curtain, though?
The grand poobah?
Yeah. Okay, I don't want the box. I don't want the envelope. Can I have what's behind the curtain instead?
I would love that. Beep, 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 beep. Yeah, beep, beep, beep. That's what I feel like.
Yeah.
Okay. Pile one. What do we need for guidance? Poised. 45 or 48. Okay. You can be assured that you're ready for anything right now. You know what you need to, your skills are sharp, and you come to a place armed with wisdom and knowledge. And you sense a new phase of your life about to begin. People respond to your confidence and trust you. This is an auspicious time to begin new things.
Kelly Grizz asks, what's behind the curtain? Go ahead and tell her.
What, are you talking about this curtain?
No. When I said, I want what's behind the curtain instead of what's in the box.
What's in the box? That makes me think of the 12 Deadly Sins or 12, that movie. What's in the box? I don't know. What's in the box? Your wildest dreams.
Let's see. You know what? It's pink. It's just big. It starts with the letter D.
Bunny! Hi, Bowie.
Bowie, right?
Hi, there's Bowie. Bowie. I said bunny.
Okay, wait, he's got his own bus.
Yeah, he's what's in the box.
He's decked out.
He's spoiled.
He's on the magic school bus, baby.
Holy crap. He's got his own bus.
I love it because you guys...
Okay, so we're going to revert to what Ari's answer is. Bowie's in the box. I'm not going to go with what I wanted to say. Sorry. I don't know if that was appropriate.
Luca.
Right. Gotcha.
Jesus, yeah. Take the wheel.
Ooh. You know what's so funny, Kelly? Last week, our church had a food distribution. I posted it for a little bit. A couple of posts about it. And it's been many years since I've stepped on hallowed ground. And I was talking to the pastor who I've been friends with for about 40 years. And I said, I swear I felt the ground crack under my feet when I stepped onto the open ground. He started laughing. He goes, shall we pray for you, brother? I said, oh, no, you don't have enough prayers. You don't have enough prayers for that today. We've got people to think. Let's do that instead. Oh, I had to be on my best behavior. I had to watch what I was saying. Every other word wanted to be an F word. Thank God that they put me next to one of these ladies of the church. I had to bite my tongue a lot.
It would be horrible. I would have to, I don't know. I don't know what I would do. I have foot and mouth syndrome.
Yeah.
I would probably cuss anyways. Maybe.
I did. And the several times I saw my parents looking at me like, this boy, he gotta go back to church. This boy, he's not reading his Bible anymore, Pastor. You know, my son, he's not coming to church anymore, Pastor. My son stopped reading his Bible, Pastor. I don't know. He does this thing in the morning where he writes for 45 minutes. I don't know what he's writing.
He's connecting.
I am.
Connecting to God.
Or something like that.
Okay, you want pile two? Okay.
Do it.
We're healing friendships, baby. Right. We got the Three of Cups going. We got the Star, which is Aquarius energy. Wow, that was like way scrolled in on the boobs. Okay, Aquarius energy.
Still is.
Ooh, rated R. Okay. And we've got the Four of Swords. So what this tells me is that a lot of you guys are going to be healing and focusing on friendship groups. What friendship means to you, feeling more connected with people, feeling like people just get you. Opening up your heart more. A lot of you guys are going to get rid of the indecision on how you're going to move forward too. It's funny. A lot of you guys, if you guys have been indecisive on a relationship or like moving around with regrets or failures, or like you're not sure if you want this relationship to move forward or if you want to walk away, you're going to be healing that. You're going to be healing that indecision and not really not feeling those despairs as much, or not letting the past get the best of you in that sense. And you guys are going to be very logical about what hindered you in the past and what didn't make you feel good enough. So a lot of you guys could be going back into the past relationships. And I know that a lot of people are like, oh, you shouldn't look at the situation. You shouldn't look at how it was. But it's like you're being very logical about what's going on in front of you. And you're understanding that a lot of it comes from like not being seen, not stating your wants, not being who you authentically were, and figuring out like your passions and what you want to go after in relationships, what relationships mean to you. And a lot of you guys are going to be healing your feelings on betrayal, how others have betrayed you, because I feel like that's been a huge theme in the past few years. Feeling of like abandonment, betrayal, isolation. A lot of you guys are starting to get the answers for those things that were haunting you or making you feel like they weren't closed. Finding, and it's not like you're necessarily getting this big bump up, but I'm seeing you're finding the strength to move forward. So it's not like you're necessarily getting results right now, but you're finding things enough that inspire you and want you to move forward, that give you the strength, that remind you of why you came here in the damn first place. And a lot of you guys are finding new relationships in all different sorts of forms and fashions. For those of you that are single, I feel like you could meet somebody through somebody else, like meet someone through friends because of this like Aquarius full moon, and Aquarius is groups of people. But I feel like also more than anything, you're learning lessons about the toxicity of the past and why you were attracted to those certain people and what you, I don't know why I keep hearing this, but what you were complacent in is what I keep feeling. And you're balancing out the imposter syndrome. It feels like the way that you're balancing out this imposter syndrome is kind of, it's scary. You're definitely facing a fear. It's not something that you're 100% comfortable with. And I feel like a lot of you might feel like you don't have enough information, or you're not experienced enough, or you're not smart enough, or you may have fears in that. You're balancing that out and you're moving forward despite it. And I think that those fears are going to wash away within the next few weeks. And you're going to be able to be in a much better emotional place where you're not fearful of sabotage or something happening from the past or some kind of fight breaking out or some bullshit. That's what it feels like. Feels like you're moving forward despite the fear. And even though these situations are fearful, the more that you show up as your authentic self, as scary as that might be, especially if you have to set boundaries or if you have to write out the gate, someone's making fun of you, that's the gold. Those are the hearts of the lessons. Like that's the gold within the shadow is what I'm hearing. The gold within the shadow. That's what it feels like. It's like you guys are putting your warrior suits on and you're moving forward. But instead this time it's not chain links or it's not chain mail. It's cloth. It's cloth. And I think they're saying that because you don't need to have the armor that you used to have anymore. You don't need to be that vicious, or you don't need to be reclusive or hiding by yourself. You're able to move forward in who you are and know that you have your own back. I don't know. I still don't know what that vision was, though, like chain link instead of cloth. I don't know why they're saying that.
I get something in my head that's like cloth of gold. I don't know if you've ever seen it. It's like a really expensive cloth that's made out of straight up gold.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Like the weaver. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I'm getting.
Yeah. It's like what kings wear.
Yeah. Yes. Like it's something of that sort. And I'm like, cloth, what the hell, you know, but it's different than cloth. And it's something that allows you to actually expose your heart. Whereas the chainmail always kept it behind a glass, always kept it behind that door. And I think that that's what the Aquarius energy really emanates anyways. It's always wanting you to get outside of that door, because Aquarian holds past life themes of either being exiled for your belief system, being carried away, being isolated for being weird or whatever. So when you're coming into the world with that energy, you innately have to understand or own your weird, because it's not like you can avoid it. You know, you can't avoid an iceberg. Icebergs are going to happen. What are you going to do to put yourself back in power? And a lot of people with Aquarius energy end up ruling their own communities or ruling communities that are very different in nature or more advanced. Tech, a lot of tech people, a lot of Aquarius tech people going on. Okay.
You got that smile again. That's a smile you see on Periscope for the first time.
That's because I'm happy and I actually like reading for you guys and I don't feel like I'm being attacked or poked all the time. It's very nice. I love it here. It's good. Comfortable.
Okay, just add on to this.
Yes.
Opposite.
You broke up for a little bit. I maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm getting old.
No,
maybe.
No.
Is this better?
Me too. She broke up for me too.
Is this better?
Perfect. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I got excited. I put my phone down on the speaker. I see. I'm like still on the cloth of gold, and when I'm seeing like this visual in my mind when you're talking about the showing your heart and the Aquarian energy of being willing to show your heart, but the Leo energy is like to put on that cloth of gold. Like you're not fighting anymore. You're putting on the cloth of gold to like be that king, to show that heart. Like that is the there's power in that.
Yes, there's power in your vulnerability, and there's power in your own discernment and knowing you have your own back. And leading with your heart instead of leading with your mind.
Mm-hmm. That.
You also said something about seeing that gold in the dark.
Mm-hmm. Gold in the shadow.
In the shadow.
Yeah.
So gold is one of the few metals, or what do they call it? For lack of a better term, one of the few metals you can actually see in the dark.
Gold. Okay, that makes total sense then. That makes total sense. And did you know that
over nickel, over silver, over aluminum, over tin? I mean, you can see it. You know it's metal.
Yeah.
But you can't differentiate what kind of metal it is. But with gold, you can actually see gold in the dark.
Wow.
And you know right away what it is.
Interesting.
Hmm. I learned that studying metal. When I was a metal salesman.
I think in Japan, when a glass breaks or when a teacup breaks, they use gold to fill in the crack and to put it back together. Okay. So the message for you guys is, whenever you find your mind drifting into the past, wondering if things could have or should have been better, or whenever you find yourself longing for the good old days, you leak power. The same is true of looking too far ahead and hoping the future will provide you a certainty. Driven by ambition, you might wander too long in a place with no substance and forget that you are here today. The past and future are illusions. Whenever you leave the present moment, you're disconnected from your inherent power. to manifest your reality with true substance. Neither past nor future can give you what you need. Now is all that counts. Come back from those eternities and be here now. All will be well and miracles will appear as if by magic in the perfect timing of spirit.
I feel like you did that for me.
Yay! I tell you what was so awesome. The fact that I could understand just about everything you were saying, even going back to when you first started about Lionsgate and Aquarius energy and Leo energy. I could understand almost all of that. I would say 92% of it. So thank you to the universe for me not having to ask you to dumb it down for me. Because I could understand. So that was great. That was great.
It's hard.
That was awesome.
It's hard when, especially like, because I study those astrology videos, right? But they have so much astrology jargon sometimes that I'm like, oh my God, you know, it's kind of hard to sit through. But you get through it. You get through it.
Yeah. Sometimes I listen to you and you just, one thing about Kelly, you get into it. And I love that.
Because it's hyperfixation.
Blah, 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 blah. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, my head, I'm thinking, oh, she's speaking in tongues again. Oh, Jesus. Talk about seriously, Jesus. Take me up.
Sometimes I feel like that. Sometimes, like when I'm channeling something or I'm going, like I'll have somebody that I'm doing a reading for, and they'll be like, "Okay, I get it." I'm like, "I know. I'm sorry. I felt the power in me. I have no." I'll stop.
I don't know. Yeah, on video when you're doing your reading, so sometimes, like once you like you start saying that, it's like, "Oh, my channel's on," and like I'm like, "Oh, I see all that. I need to say it. It has to come out of my mouth." You know.
Oh. All right, Kelly, I'm going to return the favor. I'm going to return the favor. Hold on. I'm going to let you pick from pile one or two.
Okay.
I'm going to pick cards for you. You know which cards I'm talking about, right?
Hell yeah, I do.
Okay.
I know which one I want.
Last time you called it out. I can't believe that shit. Okay, ready?
Yep.
All right. My right hand is pile one. My left hand is pile two.
Pile one.
Right hand. Okay, there we go. Ready?
Yeah.
I haven't even looked at it.
Is that it? Yes. Ace of Preverts?
Ace of Preverts. That's your card.
I like it. An ace is an ace. I don't give a shit what it is. It could be an ace of dongs, and I'd be happy.
You got the big dick energy last time. This time, you got the ace of purpose.
Yes!
That's a good card. That's a good card. So, I two things before you leave, Kelly. I know you're tired. One, Misty wanted to get a reading from you, but maybe we can do that another time. I know you've had a long day, and we talked about before we joined tonight, that there were certain things you wanted to talk about, and we'll stick to that. Because I can respect that.
Yeah, Miss B, come into one of my TikToks, and I'll give you a free reading. Come into one of my TikToks, and I'll find you. I promise.
Yeah, we keep inviting her here, and I think this is the second time she tried, but I love her. She's a good woman. I have nothing against her. I wanted you to speak about what you did tonight because that's what I think was important for the community to know what to do.
Yeah.
So I know you can always contact her or she can contact you and work out a reading then. So, Miss V, if you're watching the replay, I'm sorry you didn't get one tonight.
We love you.
We do love you. I just wanted to give Kelly a chance to speak what she was sharing with us. And secondly, tomorrow we'll be doing our second 3+me. Last week we had a fun time with just five people, I think it was. It was awesome.
You guys were, it was insane in here. It was awesome.
Saturday.
No, you know what? I'm thinking two Saturdays ago when I popped in really quick.
Yeah.
Oh, was that when I did the reading?
You did the reading for me.
Yeah, because we talked after that on the phone.
Yeah, I think that was
two Saturdays ago or something. Yeah, that was. That was. Yeah.
Yeah, so today, as I was doing my work today, I was thinking about the reading you gave me, Ari. Mm-hmm. And I have to tell you, I think I was, no, I can say with certainty that your reading was spot on. And it wasn't for the other person. It was for me. I had to swallow that one.
Sorry. Oh, I hate those.
I know.
Like, damn it.
I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, I'm down to do anything. And I'm like, okay, this is nice. I'll pull it up. And then it was just like, all right, you asked for a reading. You're going to get a reading. This is, yeah, it's not going to be like all happy. Like, ah, I forgot.
No, but it's
honest. My bad.
It was good. I needed that. But I knew today, as I was working at this renovation project, it kept hitting me left and right. I said, okay, you know what? Tonight, I need to make sure I publicly recount what I said to you when you gave me that reading and let you know that you were spot on.
Thank you.
Yay! That's awesome. So,
thank you. But we will be on 3+3 again tomorrow, Kelly. If you've got time, swing by.
I don't have the kids this weekend, so it's a lot easier for me to come in here.
We're not expecting to do readings. If you're called to do a reading, fine. If not, we just want to hang out. I mean, that's when we can let loose and eat French fries on camera. Eat pretzels on camera. And just talk. Just French talk.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Friday's going to be more formal. Saturday's going to be just friends. I do have a couple of presenters coming up. We couldn't get Snarky in tonight because of a situation that happened that needed her attention. So I did tell her that we're going to reschedule. She was really, really looking forward to it. She actually is going to share some of her beautiful arts. I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, yay.
I am actually, if you guys can point somebody who has knowledge of these things in my direction, I'm looking for somebody who can do Reiki healing for ceremonies. Also, I'm looking for another holistic healer.
Okay.
I have an herbalist that's standing by right now. We're going to be working on something together. And I have another person. Layla actually came in earlier tonight. Layla the healer. And we're talking about one thing in particular, and that was soul restoration. So basically the premise for that is when we go through past traumas in our lives, the person that we might be in this relationship in actually, I wouldn't say the word take, but now has a part of your soul with them. And it's difficult for us sometimes to get the full healing if we can't have our souls complete and intact. I'm really curious about this in this process that she's doing. So I had asked her to pop in tonight and to say hello and to become a future presenter. So Layla, if you're watching, hopefully, I would really love for you to share that with this community. It's something different. Never seen it before.
Cool.
And then, of course, it's fall season coming up, so Halloween. I have one paranormal investigation coming up, and I'm not too excited about this. I did two in the last couple of years, and one was that it was a paid one for a museum here in Hawaii, and that one just took a lot out of me. I don't know if something followed me, so I could feel it. You got to get rid of it. You know?
Yeah.
But I'm not sure, but I've been asked to do it, do an investigation with a bunch of local guys here who are YouTubers. So we'll see.
Oh, cool. That's super cool.
So that's just, I just wanted to bring different things to the community and just say, hey, this is my sharing of the pump.
Yeah.
This is what I bring to the stone soup, if you know the story about stone soup.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. For the stone suit.
Thank you, Kelly, for tonight, for joining us, for bringing us guidance and wisdom. I really do appreciate you. Again, you're welcome to join tomorrow. Ari, if you would like to stay on And offer.
Real quick before Kelly goes, I do want to say, because I forgot to say this earlier, that I specifically did this, gave this mantra, because I heard this on, well, maybe it was on Alchemist Inkwell, but they were talking about building community and how do you find community, which is super divine timing, because like literally was doing that like maybe 2 days before I saw like Kelly go live on your thing. And they had the mantra that they said was, I attract the best people. And so I just like wanted to put that out there, because that is very much in the spirit of this. And I think as you're like looking for people to share the live, I always think when you're trying to manifest or when you're focusing on a mantra, it should be something in the positive, not like, I don't, and kind of on what we were talking about, like not, I don't want all of these weirdos coming in and bringing their weird energy. Like, I only attract the best people.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's good. That's good. I like that. I like that. Thanks for the reminder, man. I needed that. I need that. Okay, well, I love you guys so much. I love you. It's an absolute honor every time I come on here. And I'll see you tomorrow night. I'll be there tomorrow. All right.
Thank
I love you. Bye, guys.
Thank you. Bye. Bowie says bye. Yeah, bed. Yeah. I don't know how he just got up here, but I think he wants attention.
Bowie wants your attention. So yeah. I was going to ask you, you tell me how he goes, if you're interested in doing the reading. If not, I think we're going to call it.
Yeah, okay, let's call it. I would do a reading, but I think that he wants, I need to get him off the bed.
No, he said he was jumping around.
He's not supposed to be able to get on the bed. I have stairs. I pushed him 2 feet off the bed, away from the bed, and then as soon as we're about to end it, he somehow managed to get on the bed, and he eats the bed.
Yeah.
It's not okay.
Okay, it's okay. Hang in there. Stick with us in chat if you want. Grizz. Josh, if you guys want to call in, now's the time.
I'm a pop-up.
I know Grizz has a lot she wants to share. Grizz? Josh, you're welcome to call in.
It's this seems to be our number. Number 5 or number 4. Josh, you got spirit fingers. I love it. My water's off. Jade Tiger.
Spirit fingers.
I love it. Yeah, that's the best.
That was great.
That was a good reading from Kelly. I mean, man, I saw you said you picked pile 2 as well.
Mm-hmm.
Did it make sense for you?
100%. I clicked with everything in my own way.
Yeah, I hear it. It just kept pounding in me. I was like, oh man. I mean, it wasn't all bad, but it was something I think I needed to hear.
Yeah. It's funny because she was saying something about like being in the moment towards the end. And like just before she said that, I was like literally going in my head about like the past and the future simultaneously about a specific thing. And then she said that and I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, see, sometimes Ellie's just got this wealth of knowledge in her head. And I like picking at it. I don't understand everything, the terminology. I know she does. But the more I listen to it, the more it makes sense.
Yeah, she's a big reader, so she definitely gets like a wealth
of knowledge.
And that's one of the things I like about her. When she finds something she wants to know about, she gets right into it.
Yeah, I know at one time she was, Grizz is trying to, let me see, I wonder if I can add,
I had to ask real quick, where do you post the live recordings?
Actually, right now, I don't. No particular reason, but I was trying to do, hey Grizz, I was trying to put it in like a Dropbox so that anybody who wants to watch it can go there instead.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Kind of yeah. like a cloud.
Yeah.
So that you could go and watch it, Ari could go and watch it. But I did find a way to, because our lives are so long, it takes up a lot of space.
Yeah.
I thought it'd be best to put it on a cloud that has a one terabyte
of memory. Yeah.
And go from there. So I'm working on that. Once I get that figured out, then I'll message you guys so you guys can go in and watch the replays. I might start doing little snippets of the live. I figured out how to pick a certain part of the live and post it to my feeds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Would you ever consider like putting it all on a YouTube page, just like reposting all the lives on there?
Josh, I just figured out where you're going to come into this. I actually thought about it. I thought about putting maybe not all, but certain videos on YouTube.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to give the impression that I'm trying to create a community to start a YouTube. It bothered me on Facebook. That's one of the things that bothered me.
What? I'm pretty sure, don't quote me, but I'm pretty sure, I don't know if it's still like a feature, that you can make your, you can like post specific videos on YouTube to like a private setting so that like only like people that you like are connected with or subscribed to can like see them.
Mm.
Yeah, you can make them private.
I thought about that, and it was on my mind yesterday, mm-hmm. because I have 30 days on Instagram before the live gets deleted. So that's why I've been slowly moving it over from Instagram to this Dropbox.
So where on Instagram do you rewatch them? Is it in your story somewhere? Or?
Only I can watch it. That's the thing. I don't want it from only me to watch it. It goes into archive.
I see.
I don't want to just do that just for me to watch.
I'm not super Instagram savvy, so that's one thing I wasn't like super sure on.
No, I do know someone, but I have to have a conversation with this person.
Mm-hmm.
And he is well aware of the community. He knows Kelly really well. He knows all of us pretty good. I just have to have the conversation with him. I'm not sure if I'm ready. But I thought about it last week, and I said, man, I want people to watch the replay.
Tamara's saying if you save it, it can go in the tabs between your bio and your posts.
Here's my issue. There are certain people who are on the approved list to join the live that are not necessarily, or there are certain people who are not approved, because these are people who do not approve.
Gotcha. So you want like the lives to be kind of like replayable for like the people who are in them.
Yes.
I see. Okay, I gotcha.
Yes. So like I had to figure out how to do a compress the live that Ari gave a reading for me and send it mm-hmm. to Kelly because she wanted to watch it. So Ari, I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you about it, but Kelly asked if she could see you do a reading. She said she never saw you do a reading, but she said that was awesome. Private group with the link. Okay, gotcha.
Hi, Grizz.
Yeah, I can say who is approved to join the lives. But if I put it into my feeds, everybody in my family is received.
Got you.
That's it. Grizz, you're quiet over there, Grizz.
Organizing away.
Yeah. She is. I can't hear you, Grizz. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I can't hear you either.
Sorry.
He was on me.
I was just trying to organize myself because, you know, with the work. So I now because this deck that, you know.
I'm getting like
Chris, a I think you got to move up closer to your mic, Chris. I'm sorry.
Oh, you know what? Can you guys hear me better?
Yes.
Okay, sorry. So yeah, so I have this this deck that I love, but like it was basically it's not being printed. So I had to download the little booklet.
Mm-hmm.
And so I printed it out, but I'm trying to do little cards, like, you know, cut them up, make them all perfect. And then I want to probably do like some little, what is it? When you put them in the plastic, laminate them.
Oh, laminate yeah. Them.
Official. But right now it's still in the works. It's still in the print form. So you can see, I just like barely like printed them.
I used to have a deck just like that. That was a deck that was like strictly online, and you could only print it off. Like they wouldn't produce them, and I had them laminated, and I love that deck, but I lost it a long time ago.
Really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's the problem here, and so I'm trying to organize it, and I haven't gotten to it yet.
Nice.
That's what I was doing.
So let me tell you. Let me share a secret with you guys. Then, since it's so infinite, there's only four of us. This past week, in the evenings like this, I was trying to study tarot cards, the meaning of each of the pentacles, the swords, I'm going to get this wrong. The
symbolism?
Yes. I'm trying to think of the word. It's something arcana.
Oh, the major and
the minor. Oh, the major and minor
arcana. Major and minor arcana cards. Gotcha. So I was studying that. And I'm a writer. I like to write shit down. I went through four booklets just like these. Just this week. Of just studying tarot.
Nice. With, very clean
what
notes.
Each card means, and but a lot of it, I think, is interpretation, if I'm not wrong.
Mm-hmm.
The cards can only guide you into what the meaning of the cards is, but a lot of it is based on interpretation. I guess, and also you as a reader understanding what the person you're reading for would like to know. That right?
Yeah.
Right.
Each deck can be different too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I guess. I heard that.
Yeah.
I heard that. And the reason why I'm doing, I think I shared it before. Someone is sending me a deck. I've never read tarot before. I've seen it done. I'm curious about it. I wouldn't mind learning because it's just something else under my belt. Understanding your deck. There you go. Understanding. Mm-hmm. So, I actually want to create my own deck with an elephant theme. And I'm use excited. The elephant as the figures instead of the queen or the empress, the knight, the page. And somehow use elephants. I don't know if that goes against tarot rooms or whatever
there,
it's called.
There's like, decks where it's strictly cats. There's decks that are strictly like certain animals. There's literally hundreds of thousands of decks that are out there.
Okay.
So yeah, whatever your deck is what it's supposed to be.
Yeah, there's like
I've been called to actually make one for myself.
I want a copy. I can't wait.
I have an idea. I have a lot of the pictures of it, and I'm looking for an artist I think Ari and I kind of talked about this a little bit. I'm looking for an artist to possibly help me to draw out the cards. Oh, there are no rules. Oh, I see.
Yes.
I just don't want to offend anyone in the tarot community, I guess.
I mean, honestly, there's always going to be someone you're going to offend.
That is true.
Because everybody has their own ways. Some people are super strict about it. Some people don't care what other people do. Some people are only strict about what they do.
Yeah.
So.
No one's
people are, you're going to throw a rock in any community and you're going to offend somebody, especially in these day and age.
Mm-hmm.
We elephants, we don't throw rocks. We throw boulders. So. That's the difference.
Right.
That's the difference. Chris, what's on your mind, Chris? You've been quiet on it.
Exactly, Ari.
Fuck the haters.
I know.
Your cane looks just like a G. Huh? Her cane looks just like a G.
I didn't hear you. What?
Her cane. It looks just like a G.
My audio.
That's great.
You're not to type it
can
out.
You hear, can you hear me now?
Yeah. Maybe?
Okay. Yeah.
My Wi-Fi, I don't know.
Okay, try now. Can you hear me better?
All right.
I haven't eaten in 5 weeks. Sorry, I feel your pain.
Oh, yeah, Josh. I didn't want to call you out with this, but I hope you're doing better. Hope you're feeling better.
I am doing very much better.
Yeah. Feeling.
The pain is like almost gone. I'm pretty much back to my old activities with like only slight defects. So.
Awesome. So good.
Things are healing. Yeah. Doctor says I'm healing like super fast. So.
You're
sick.
Ari's asking if you're sick.
No, I'm not sick. I had surgery. So I had a pre-op diet and I'm on my post-op diet. And it was 3 weeks pre-op and I'm on my second week post-op.
Oh, dang.
Mm-hmm. So we're on week 5.
Diets. I gotta get back on mine. I gotta do my cleanse. I can feel it. My body's asking me.
Trust me, a cleanse? I feel so light. I felt weak for a while, but and I like crave food. I get stuck on like YouTube or like Facebook food videos. Like it's like social media knows I'm hungry.
I know, so bad. Like yeah, I need to be not eating any dairy, no gluten, no grains. Like yeah, no.
Alright, to answer your question, I had about 80% of my stomach removed. Mm-hmm.
Oh my
so
god.
I have 6 holes in my abdomen from the laparoscopic surgery. The one that they pulled the stomach out of, which is like totally on the other side of my abdomen, really hurts the worst. But you know, it's not bad. I mean, as far as surgeries go, I was expecting it to hurt way worse.
Yeah. So is it intestines? They had to cut like intestines?
No, just the stomach. So I got a gastric sleeve done. So basically my stomach now looks like a banana. So they cut out like the majority of my stomach and including the part of the stomach that creates the hormone for hunger. So
I need that done.
Right. Well, if you're really BMI is at least 30, you qualify.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yep.
I know I had a friend that I used to work with that had that the GP done, mm-hmm. and he had to really be careful when he ate.
Yeah.
He couldn't overeat because he would just be in pain.
Mm-hmm.
Felt really crappy for him.
Yeah. I have some friends that do, and they, yeah, same thing. That's what they would say.
My mother got the gastric bypass. My sister got the sleeve. A friend of ours got the sleeve. And another friend of ours is about to get the sleeve in like a week or two.
Oh,
So we're like a big group of us. But honestly, I was like expecting it to be like a lot harder. My doctor said like I'm one of her like weird rare patients that like, because most people like just taking little sips like multiple times throughout the day kind of like hurts because your stomach is supposed to only be able to have like 2 to 5 ounces of space in it right now at my stage. But I'm able to put in like at least 100 to 150 ounces a day fluid. So that's apparently unusual. But she said like I'm healing super fast. I'm not having any complications. She's like, I would know it. If I would, I would feel it or be able to see it. But yeah, so I'm like a rare case.
That's good. I'm glad you're doing that.
You know, if you do like, if you're doing like all your energy healing, that's probably what's helping you.
No, absolutely. And I definitely have like a huge support system right now that's like sending me a lot of good energy right now. So it's, and I'm not really the best patient. I don't rest very well when I'm told to rest, but when I like am not told to rest, I'll rest all the time. But I decided to get it because last year, exactly 1 year prior to my surgery, August 2nd, I was at the end of a very big depression, probably the biggest one I had in my life. And I was 512 pounds, the biggest I'd ever weighed. I couldn't even reach my toes to put on shoes or fit shoes. My feet were super swollen. I was so out of shape. I was living in my van. It was a whole thing. And so I went to the doctors because I was having trouble like seeing one day and I was diagnosed as diabetic. And so then from that day on, I, your birthday, Ari. Hey,
August 2nd, right?
Yeah, right. Happy birthday.
Her birthday just
So I was diagnosed as diabetic. They put me on metformin. And then a month later, I went to see my primary and I got on some other medication. And so from that point on, I decided to, like, go through the journey. And when I was in Oregon, they make you, like, try medication for 6 months before you can get the surgery. And so I started the process out there, and then I restarted it when I moved out here, which is a whole separate thing. And so I passed all the things I needed to pass. I went to all the people I needed to see. I lost a bunch of weight on my own. By the time of the day of surgery, I was down to 381, and today I'm at 354.
So wow, that's I've good.
Lost 158 pounds since last year.
For you. It's not easy. It's not easy.
It's not. So a lot of people were like, well, you've lost all this weight. Like, why would you like still go through with the surgery? And 380 has been like my weight. Hi, Starry.
Hi.
Has been like my weight for like a long time. And it's like really difficult to get past that point for me. I'd have to put like a lot of daily effort. Mm-hmm. All very long time to be able to get past that. When I did the Pacific Crest Trail, I was able to get down to like 300, but I was also hiking with 80 pounds on my back for 20 miles a day. So that would kind of like shed the weight off. But even then, I was only able to lose 80 pounds.
Only, did you just hear what you said? I was only able to lose 80 pounds.
Well, when so I'm in my weight class, 80 pounds isn't that much.
But still, you're a human being just like anybody else. Yeah. Show me anybody that can just say, oh, I only lost 80 pounds. I'll tell you this much. I've been trying to diet myself, so I cut back at least 37 pounds because, like you, I was tired of trying to put on my socks and huffing and puffing. My diet was bad. I ate the wrong times. I ate the wrong stuff. And I just kept going there. Because I was trying to fill a void. And part of what was kind of like opened my mind about that last year, about going on a diet, was my kids. My son said, Dad, don't you want to see me graduate from high school? Oh!
Hey. That's savage.
He's right.
Yeah.
He was right. I think at most I was 350 maybe at one time, and that was about a year and a half ago now. My goal is to get down to just about 200 pounds, and I've got about maybe 40 more to go. But still, it was a long process for me. So for you to say I only lost about 80 pounds, yeah, okay, it's just, yeah, I had more pounds on me, but Damn, that's an accomplishment in itself.
Yeah, don't downplay really that.
Yeah, you gotta give yourself that pat on the back because you deserve it. You work.
Yeah,
it.
You're a Leo.
I see, but I'm also a Virgo rising and a Scorpio moon, so I'm very internal.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
I can be like anybody's cheerleader and make them like smile in a heartbeat. But myself, that's a different story. I mean, don't get me wrong. Right. I can pass by a mirror and stop and say that's a good looking individual and like be stuck for about 3 hours.
I feel that. With Aquarius, I'm just like, give me attention. That's too much attention. I'm done, please.
I try to tell people all the time, I'm like, listen, when you get out of the shower, just stare at yourself in the mirror until you feel comfortable. Mm-hmm. You know, because honestly, eventually you'll start to feel like comfortable in your own skin.
Heck yeah.
It's hard. I mean,
nobody else has to wear it but you might as well be comfortable while you're in it, right?
Yeah,
you're stuck in this human skin, this earth suit. Exactly. So you know, exactly. It's yours, own it.
Mm-hmm.
So I was gonna ask you about like your spiritual. My mom's, I don't know, she'd love me spilling her baggage on the internet, but she's in OA, and I mean, she's been like a recovered, she's been in the program since I was like, since I can remember, and she had some addiction like way before I was ever born, which is why Kelly like meshed with me so much.
Who are we talking about?
My mom.
Oh, okay. I didn't hear that part.
Yeah. I'm just curious about like, I don't know if it's like too personal, but like you're working on healing your spiritual relationship with food. That's something that, I mean, you know, it's like minor. It's like, I don't want to be that person that's like, oh, I gained like a tiny bit of weight, when like, I know your journey is like,
no, very honestly, different. It's fine. Everybody has their own, you know, personal battles. Mm-hmm. And it's just as big for some person as it is for another. Numbers and stuff like that doesn't really matter in comparison. Mm-hmm. But for me personally, my biggest thing with food is I did it. It was a reaction out of my depression. Because for me, especially last summer, which got me to 512, which I swore to myself I'd never get over 400. And then after I was over 400 for a couple weeks, I was like, okay, well, I guess this is a new normal. And then I swore I'd never get to 500. And if I got to 500, then I'd like really change. And that kind of mm-hmm. was the tipping point. Was when I found out that they weighed me at the hospital that I was 512 pounds and I was diabetic, which it only took me 4 months to get out of being in remission from that. So no more diabetes. Officially remiss.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
That's big.
Because I was like, I'm not about sticking myself with a needle every day, which is kind of ironic because I was also taking a medication that helped me not be hungry anymore that also required me to stick myself with a needle every day. But anyways, back to the food. So mm-hmm. for me, it was kind of a way for me to, in my head, fast track basically offing myself. Yes. And when in reality, it didn't happen that way, it just kind of damaged my body slowly over time, making me more debilitated and suffering. I was like, okay, maybe this isn't the way to go. Mm-hmm. So I was like, let's, make some drastic change. And honestly, I can't stress this enough to anybody I talk to about any problem they have. Until you say enough is enough for you, it's not going to be enough. You know, you can say it in front of other people's faces, but until you say it to yourself, it's never enough.
I literally had the same thing kind of happen to me, but opposite. When I was 19, I always had depression as a teenager, and I didn't really get on any medication for it till I was like 18. And I still was like spiraling, and I moved out of my mom's house, and I just like really let it, it got really bad. And for me, that was like not eating. Like, I'm not an anorexic. I don't think I'm an anorexic. I don't think I have an eating disorder now, but like, I kind of did the opposite where I was like, I just really didn't like myself. And I just was like, you know, like if I stop eating, this is a way for me, but it was like, people won't notice if I like disappear. And I like wrote like a really emo poem about like, if I just disappear slowly, like, nobody will notice, which was stupid because like people noticed, you know, like, you know, I remember I ran into somebody on the bus and that knew me in high school. And like, I'm not gonna, I lost like 20 pounds in 2 months. Like,
oh, and wow.
I'm not a super big person on my frame.
That's noticeable for people.
It was. It was like I went down like I went from like a size like 10 to a size 2 in like 2 months. Like it was fast. It was fast. And like I ran into somebody on the bus and they just like looked at me and they were like, "You lost weight." And they just kind of like, not necessarily in a super helpful way, just kind of like in a concerned way, but like definitely is like the mind body relationship is so huge. And that's been like a interesting part of like I just finally gained back like that last bit of weight that I had lost, like from you know. And I haven't really like I've had like been able to like put activity in my life and schedule it in for a very long time. And I think it's like now that I'm gaining it back, I've kind of had to like sit down with myself and say like, are you giving your body what it needs? And like truthfully, like I'm not kind of make a debut. Truthfully, I'm not like giving myself the activity that I need, like the, and you know, like when I take a walk, like that's when I reconnect with myself. And like when I get into nature, that's, you know, and so, yeah.
I totally get that because I'm the same way. Like I will put off doing something that I know I'll enjoy doing when I'm doing it. And I'll bitch about having to do it up until I start doing it.
Yeah.
Literally, I will fight myself about everything that will help me until I do it.
Me too. And
for me, I was like a binger, so I didn't do the purging. I tried the purging and it was just really too difficult to make myself throw up. So I just stuck with the binging. So I would like, I'd binge on like food in one session and then like I wouldn't eat for like 2 days later. So, like, I'd binge. Mm-hmm. And then, like, I'd normalize, and then I'd eat, like, one meal a day for, like, a month, and then I'd have, like, a weekend where I did not stop eating all day and every day. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it was just, you know, because I was enjoying myself. Sometimes it was because I was depressed, or sometimes it was just because I was bored and I had absolutely nothing to do.
Boredom eating. It's so hard.
It's hard. It's really hard. Especially, like, if you're alone or if you're just, like, sitting down watching TV. Like, I make it a point, like, I won't eat when I'm watching TV. The only time I eat when I'm watching something is at the movie theater.
That is a good rule.
Yeah.
I should consider it.
And, like, I mean, I don't drink really much anymore, but, like, I made a rule that, like, if I'm going to drink, like, I only drink to feel even better, not drink to feel better.
Mm.
Okay, so here's a newsflash. I'm a drinker. I'm not a binger. But I, like you guys were talking about, depression. I had that. I went through
that. And I think it's like a prerequisite to be like in our field.
Yeah. I think the only person that didn't see it was me.
Right.
And it happened after my degree. Right, exactly. I didn't get the memo. You know, that kind of thing. But I did everything I shouldn't have to my body. I binge, I ate. I was even at work. I had bottles of Jack Daniels in my work bag. I was a manager at the time. Airline manager, of all places. I had a bottle of Jack in my bag. And I would travel to different islands I want to say like a manager of the West Coast, California, as well as all islands in Hawaii. I always traveled with a bottle of liquor. I had a couple in my car. I had some in my office. It was special in place, and nobody knew, or at least I thought nobody knew.
Right.
Wow.
My boys saw that part of me, and that was
different. Yeah.
And we were not even divorced. They weren't even moved out yet of the house that we shared. And oh, I tell you, it was just one big cluster. So I drank, I ate, I smoked, I partied, I did everything I wanted to do that I didn't do for 12 years while I was married.
Mm-hmm.
And it hit me one day, and I looked in the mirror. In the mirror, I was like, man, that's not the same guy I remember 12 years ago.
Yeah.
It's somebody that's hurt. It's somebody that's angry. It's somebody who needs help. It's somebody who doesn't see it. But I didn't know where to help it. I was taking Paxil, an antidepressant, at one time. And I was seeing I was getting help, professional. I'll be honest, I hated it. I felt like I was back at Catholic church where, as an altar boy, I would have to go to church every Sunday and be almost being forced to.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't get fed. I didn't know what I was there. It's like, for me, didn't have a drug. Same thing with seeing professional help. I don't know why I was there. I did it because somebody asked me, somebody close to me asked me to do it. But I didn't feel any help. I didn't feel like I was getting that way. And so I reverted back to my old ways. And it got me into a lot of trouble. A lot of trouble. And including with the law. But that's another story. But I'm glad I was able to, like, hey, you know what? This shit kind of stopped. You're ruining your own life and you got nobody else to blame but yourself. Your two sons are not even in high school yet. And you're destroying yourself. How selfish of you to do that when you're not even thinking about your two sons? And I had a daughter as well, a stepdaughter. And they all saw it, except for me. But like you said, yes, there's a prerequisite of some kind of a trauma that we go through until we actually see, okay, wait a minute, time out. We gotta stop. We gotta do something.
Being a human is trauma.
Facts. Facts. People talk about, like, oh, like, only some people have, like, childhood trauma. Like, no, no, no. It's not about childhood trauma. It's living is a trauma. Being alive is the trauma.
Yeah. A lot of people, they say, it's like, hell doesn't exist. You are in hell. You know? We're all in hell. Like, you know, life is...
That's what my mom told me growing up, because, you know, being Jewish, like, we don't believe in hell. And she's always taught me, like, hell is what you make, you know?
Yep.
And who better to be the makers of our own hells than ourselves?
Yeah. It's like, have you ever seen The Good Place?
Right? I love me. Okay, so when me and Kelly go live on TikTok, we're doing this thing where we go through, like, TV shows, and we're gonna, like, pick the zodiacs for all of the signs and, like, explain why they are. And I'm super excited about it, because The Good Place is the first one that we started on. And I'm so excited. That's such a good show. I forking love that show.
I freaking love that show, too. I feel like Michael's kind of a Gemini, but then, like...
Yeah.
Yeah? Right? Yeah. He's got, like, he likes to be... He's so, like, two poles, you know?
Yes, 100%. And he's a very... Gemini's
are cold. Really?
No, they got two sides. They do each extreme. Michael's like the devil, but also like to be like really happy and a good person, and he's like really good sometimes, but he's also loves being bad. Mm-hmm. You know?
Okay.
Very Gemini.
I really?
Isn't that the Gemini thing? It's like they'll do one thing and then they're like, actually no, it's the opposite.
Very, very much. Very polar opposites in one.
Go ahead.
She showed me this astrology, like a video of this astrologer, and it, within it, he said something along the lines of like, "Yeah, I know you guys are thinking this is all the best astrology ever." And he's like, "No, gosh, you're probably judging me for that." And like, it's honestly, it's not that good. And like, I just was waiting when he said that. I was like, "Where's the Gemini?" And then like within a couple minutes, he's like, "Yeah, so I'm Gemini rising or something."
See, like, and I have, like, I'm a little snobby when it comes to astrology, and for one reason only, and that's because I get annoyed with people who hate on astrology, but they only think it's about your sun sign.
Right.
And I can't have a conversation with you because you can't even understand what I'm talking about.
Complicated. So, a lot more.
My sun sign is Gemini.
Sorry. Wasn't trying to come at you or anything.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
Do you feel like that's accurate?
I want to, again, I'm going to be really honest. Possibly.
Do you feel attacked?
No, not really.
What's your moon sign?
Pisces.
Pisces.
Grizz remembers.
What's your rising?
He's an emotional wreck.
Rising?
What?
He's an emotional wreck.
So also a Pisces.
I'm a...
Oh, man, I'm just coming for all y'all.
Wait, you're a what?
I'm a Pisces.
You're a Pisces? Okay.
Taurus moon.
Taurus moon. You know, that's probably my favorite placement for Taurus is the moon.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know a whole lot. I just remember.
Taurus get luxury the way that Leos do. I had a Taurus roommate, and we both were, like, very much about, we need to get our spa things, and, like, we like our face masks. But Taurus are very much, like, the in-home luxury, where Leos are like, okay, I got my face mask done, now I need to go shine somewhere.
Yeah. Anybody want to guess my rising sign? Grizz, if you know it, don't say it.
I don't think
Wait, okay, so you're a Gemini sun, Pisces moon. I want to say either Libra or Sag.
Yeah, I'm going Earth or Water.
I was Virgo? Sending it to you. No. You, Josh got it. Sagittarius.
Really? Is Sag?
Damn.
I was thinking Sagittarius. I was like, well, so I was like, well, maybe Libra, because I'm like, maybe there's some more air. But I knew it had to be like, I knew it wasn't Earth. Sag rising. Interesting. I don't know that many Sag rising people.
Isn't Kelly a Sag rising?
No, she's Virgo rising. She's Sag moon.
All right.
Yeah.
Somewhere in there.
Yep.
Complicated. Yeah.
I only have Sag in my north node. That's the only spot.
Shut up. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait. Was this the other thing that we have that's the same?
Probably. Well, and you're probably, because you're 29, right?
Yeah, we're like a couple days apart, huh?
Okay, so we're both in our Saturn return, Saturn Aquarius.
Are we in our Saturn return yet?
Yeah, we're in it. We're almost out of it.
We are?
Yeah, next March, girl. It ends next March. Aww. It started last year. March of last year to March of 2023.
I could see that. I could totally see that.
Yeah.
See, this is so funny. I have this vision in my head. The four of us are in the playground, so we're talking, and we all have something to contribute to the conversation. And then all of a sudden, the two of you start chatting, and I'm like, I'm going to go play now. I'm going to go in the jungle gym, because I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. I mean,
I do like it, though, because at least other people who, like, are at least exposed to, like, astrology and other types of, like, spiritual metaphysical things, like they can at least like have some kind of input, whereas like somebody who's completely outside of that zone, like it's hard to even have a conversation with them because you're having to stop every 2 seconds.
Yeah
it was like, it was one of those moments where you two were talking in tongues. Sorry. Again, you know, just like Kelly, like,
sorry.
Are we bringing like... back here
talking.
No, it's okay.
I literally become like a child when like I get excited about a conversation and I just like
me too. It's one of my hyperfixations, it's one of my deep dives, and you know, like I did my first oracle, got my first oracle deck when I was probably like 12.
Mm-hmm.
Because my mom used to do like art mediumship, and right. Yeah, it's cool, really? But she doesn't do that anymore. Yeah, she used to channel and, like, went to, like, a trance and paint pictures.
What happened?
Yeah, I forget that because she doesn't do that. She's a nurse now.
Okay, wait, I started doing that.
Did you?
Yeah, I draw circles.
Nice. You get visions and stuff?
Yeah.
You like your way?
Yeah. I find I can concentrate better with I'm doing drawing these circles, and then I start to get clearer messages. I just started that like maybe 2 weeks ago.
When I first started channeling, before, like, I found, like, my zhuzh and how to do it, I was trying different, like, modalities, and somebody suggested that, like, I start drawing. And, like, mm-hmm. not something specific, but, like, just put the pen to the paper and, like, see what happens. And so I would come up with these weird squiggly signs, but the moment I opened my eyes and I saw whatever it was, I could see, like, a symbol or something that I would recognize, like, that would specifically give, like, the message that I was trying to get. Mm. I loved it.
Cool. Do you know what automatic writing is?
Mm-hmm.
I've heard of
it. Can you tell me? Because I don't know what it is.
So automatic writing is like basically another form of channeling. It's basically a lot of people describe it as like them not even being present in it. It's basically like kind of like a download, but like you're like automatically just writing. You don't know what you're writing until it's over. It's completely just channeled and then you have whatever you wrote.
So it's not like stream of consciousness where you just write every word that pops into your head?
Maybe for some people. I mean, the people that I know that do it, that's just how they've described it to me.
Interesting.
It's not my channeling. Channeling's not my easiest.
Yeah.
There's this, like, medium that I follow. And she like, kind of gets so into it where realize what she's writing.
Mm-hmm. It's like when Kelly's in live and sometimes she gets like this really totally out of the ballpark like vision of something. It's like that, but like, and you have no idea where it comes from or what it has to do with it, but like you're like writing. Mm-hmm. And then like, yeah, you don't even like see it until it's done.
I've seen her do that before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she does it occasionally.
Yeah.
I guess channeling is my strong suit then, if I had to, like, not. Oh, yeah. I mean, if I had to think about it, that's, like, sorry, I lost my train of thought.
In my personal experience, most females are easier channelers than males. Mm-hmm. Well, simply from my personal thought process is mm-hmm. because their vibrations are just easier to connect to spirit than mm-hmm. men's ours, because men's are usually a lot lower vibration than females.
Unless that male has a very high feminine energies or
agree.
Divine,
yeah,
feminine,
yeah,
energy?
Not necessarily even feminine energies, just like women just vibrate on like a different plane than men. Typically, not always, there's always exceptions to the rules, but like typically women just vibrate on a much more open plane. They're able to access emotions more, be vulnerable more, connect to spirit more. Right. It's like
in real life women, they fall in love with their heart first. Men, they fall in love with their eyes first.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's basically it.
Yeah.
I don't know.
There are the in betweens and the gray areas. But...
we're wired different.
Yeah.
I think meditation's been the big part of that, you know, for me.
Oh, fully.
I feel like, I don't know, it's like I was saying with Kelly, it's like you go into an altered state of consciousness. That's kind of what I was trying to do with that meditation. Not trying to get, like, people in an altered state of consciousness, but, like, I feel like I tend to sense, like, the energy of things. And when I start to go into a meditation and use, like, visualization, I don't know. It's hard to describe. You, like, access something else.
Mm-hmm. I love this.
I like it though because you did kind of like opposite of what I do. I start from above me down to the mm-hmm. feet. You mm-hmm. start from the feet up, and I liked it. It was nice because it was like a whole different way for me to do it, and it was fun.
Because I usually do it the head down, but I felt a really strong need to ground, mm-hmm. and so I flipped it. It was kind of intuitive. It was just like, I don't know. I felt like I could prep, but then like, I don't know. I just wing it a lot of the time.
Honestly, half of your audio for me was, like, cut out, but what I could hear, damn, I was like, oh my god, yeah, I like, really like this. But, like, it didn't even matter that your audio cut out, because, like, I was very in tune with it, and I was, like, I got goosebumps in the middle of it. I was, like, very open. Like, it was, yeah, like, it was great.
I gotta stop putting my speaker on the ground. Like, you know how the speaker's on the bottom and the flat part of your phone?
That's very irritating, I know. Well, I'll be FaceTiming someone and be like, can you like not hold your phone with your fingers underneath the microphone?
The thing you can't hear. Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, but yeah, recently about like somebody was talking about like how to, oh my gosh, it was so like, it was somebody who does like mediumship and like also like what's it called, like the ghost thing with the spirit boxes, paranormal investigator, that.
Yes.
And they were, you know, like paranormal investigators, they do that.
Was it Sean?
No, her name is, oh my god,
Amanda.
No, Rebecca the Ghost Guide. Mm-hmm. Really cool. It's really interesting. She's got this whole like ghost skits thing, and it's like just kind of like about her experience in mediumship, and like she's like found some, she's got like friend ghosts to hang out, and it's fun. It's really fun.
I lived with somebody who had resident ghosts that she and I communicated with regularly.
They nice?
Scary.
I mean, it can be. I've always looked at everything outside of the norm, like all the unknown things. To me, I've always tried to take the fear out of it immediately, mm-hmm. Just because it is easier for me to connect to it and learn from it than it is to like have the fear for it. Like, I have fear of things that most normal people find totally easy, like communicating like in a party. Right.
Yeah, like making a phone call.
Literally.
I think in my experience in the last 3 years, there are only two spirits that I was really afraid of. And one of them was my grandmother. I was in her house, sleeping in the living room, and I was house-sitting. And the people that are living there, my brother and his family, there was a certain picture of my grandmother hanging on the wall, and he took it off and put a mirror there for his wife and put the picture away. And the picture's from 1944 or something like 45, 44. He put it away. I had this dream of my grandmother standing in the living room, looking at me and pointing at the wall where the picture was hanging. And she was upset. Now, that was the first spirit I saw that just freaked me the fuck out. And said, I was telling Kelly, I don't want to see people. I want to see spirits. This is the kind of shit I don't want.
Yeah.
But then there was, when I first started working with Kelly, she's mentoring me, there was a little girl, a teenage girl that passed away 2 minutes away from my house. And she ended up showing me herself how she died. And it was the spookiest, scariest thing I've ever saw. And I had to text Kelly right away. I said, Kelly, I don't want to do this. I don't want to open myself up to this. This is the kind of shit that I didn't want to have happen. Mm-hmm. I don't want this.
I don't think you have to, though. Like, if
you don't.
Yeah, no. You don't have to. You can just slam that shit.
Yeah, that's how I was introduced to spirits, was they would say hello to me by making me feel how they died. Like, the first time I can remember it happening was my friend and I were just sitting down in the living room one day, and we were, like, watching TV or whatever. And then the TV, like, stopped, and, like, we both could hear this deep, deep baritone voice singing a song, and it was like, before I'll be a slave, I'll be buried in my grave. It was like an old song, and then like all of a sudden, like my whole left arm went numb, and then like my heart felt like it was exploding, and my head felt like it was on fire, And I was, like, debilitated for, like, 3 hours. And then I was like, what's going on with me? What's going on? Should we call an ambulance? Like, I feel like I'm dying. And she's like, oh, that happens to me all the time. I was like, what happens to you all the time?
Just have a heart attack. It's fine.
She's like, that's just the ghost telling you how they died. I was like, well, can they, like, stop it? And yeah. So she showed me some techniques, like, to try and kind of, like, you know, be like, okay, thanks for showing me, but, like, keep it back.
Energy, like,
that's what Kelly was saying, to set boundaries.
Yeah. No, boundaries are the language I abide by.
So, this little girl, she is, at the time she passed away, she was 16. She was thrown out of the car on the main drag, 2 minutes away from my house. And she was found by somebody who was walking their dog that night, blah, blah, blah. And she was trying to show me what happened to her. And I asked Kelly, what can I do? So she told me, set boundaries. I said, look, I'm new to this. I don't want to see how you die. There's something you need to say. And I live alone. This is at 9:30 at night. I live alone. I'm about to go to bed. The last thing I want to do is sleep with all my lights on. So I said, look, I'm new to this. I don't want this in my house. I don't want to know. If you have something you need to tell me, then please show me, tell me. Other than that, I don't want to sleep with one eye open and all my lights on.
Yeah.
Okay, it stopped. The next morning, I got up, I felt good, brushed my teeth, grabbed my cup of coffee, and then I saw the little girl again. She was standing at the same place in the stairs, going upstairs to my house. And so she was trying to show me this purse that she had. And it was in the back of the boyfriend's car. So the boyfriend got investigated. He was a known drug dealer.
Damn. And
they called him, he's innocent, nothing wrong with him. And so I ended up contacting this girl's mom because she came on the news and said, hey, if anybody knows what happened to my daughter, will you please let me know? So I called her out of the blue and said, listen, it's going to sound weird, but there's a message from your daughter she wants you to know. In the back of someone's car, it is a gray car. It's kind of a beat-up car, and it has one blue door. And you need to go into that car in the back seat. And you're going to find a bag, some kind of a bag. It might be her bag. And then they called the police and went over to the boyfriend's house because it has one blue door. And they opened up that door. And shoved underneath the seat was this girl's purse that had all of her blood on it. They tested it and everything like that. It ended up, he went to trial and he was found guilty. He admitted to murdering her because she was going to leave him. Now, this guy is 19 years old, and she was 60 at the time. And once everything played out, once everything was done and he was found guilty, I didn't see the girl again.
You
brought the message.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my introduction to mediumship.
Baptism by fire.
Yeah.
So I called Kelly on that. I said, Kelly, I don't want to do this shit. She goes, it's okay, but you still need to learn to set your boundaries. Mm. So before I go to bed, I set boundaries around my house, around my bed. I make sure I recall my energies and send back all the negative shit to all the negative people. You can have this back because I don't want it. And I sleep good at night. For most part. I'm old, so we don't need enough sleep, you know? Yeah, I think it was a test for me.
Yeah,
and I don't know if I passed because the first couple hours I was like, I don't want this shit, man. Get the fuck out of my house. I don't need this. It's not what I signed up for.
Go ahead.
I think that we have those things happen because we wouldn't believe it, because magic happens all the time and we just think that it's like a coincidence. And for me personally, like, I've had like, since I was a kid, it's happened a couple of times where, like, I think about somebody, like, intrusively, and I find out that they died the next day. And just like, and it happened recently. It happened during COVID, where I had this teacher that I worked with, and fucking sucked. It sucked. We were all like saying goodbye for the semester, and he was like waving to the students saying bye. And he's like, "Okay, I'll see you next year." And then in my head, I just thought, "No, you won't. You're gonna have a heart attack." Oh wow, I didn't choose to think that. That was not my thought. I didn't want to have that thought, and I tried to like brush it aside, and like it had happened like for not that clear, but versions of this, and like some like really shitty versions of this had happened like about 5 times, and like he had a heart attack. He didn't come back. That was the last time I saw him, and it's just like, really? That's how you're gonna, but like I can't say that, you know, like yeah. I'm in my own skin. I experienced this. I had that feeling. I had that thought. It wasn't my thought, you know, and then it happened, you know. Like, I can't deny that.
Yeah. And the universe is sitting back laughing, going, "Oh, welcome to the world of spiritualism."
Yeah, are you still going to deny it? Are you going to deny it really. Now? You know?
Yeah. Spirit likes to introduce us in, like, crisis mode. Like, here's the crisis. Let's see how you handle it.
Or it's like that. It's like that sibling that's like, "I'm not touching you, I'm not touching you, I'm not touching you," until they're like poking you in your face, exactly. You know, like,
Yep. You feel it? They're touching me.
Yeah, I was telling Kelly that too when I first started, when she first started to work with me. I said, you know, I've seen things throughout my life, but I've always brushed it off. I ignored it. I didn't want anything to do with it. She said, the more you push it away, the more persistent it'll be.
Yeah.
I was like, oh.
Make peace all right. With it.
Yeah. So I learned, well, I did the wrong thing. I think I did the wrong thing from the beginning. All right. I'm opening myself up. Show me what you want to show me. And it was like, okay, here you go.
Careful what you ask for.
Now it's like, yeah, I ain't got time for that. I'm busy. No, you want to send, give me a message. It's fine. Otherwise, don't bother me setting my barrier, my perimeters up. I don't want that shit. Get that out.
Crazy.
In fact, I had a conversation with a high school friend a couple of days ago, and she said, "I've been watching your Instagram post. This is not the guy you were in high school." I said, "You're right, I'm not." She said, "I know you said you have certain abilities, gifts, that mind you, but you still have problems." I said, "You're right, I do have problems. I'm human. I did say I have certain abilities. I didn't say I was cocky. Even right. People who have certain abilities, we have just the same amount of problems like everybody else. We go through the same thing. We hurt the same way. We get sad the same way. We bleed the same way. We're human."
Trust me, if we could evolve physically, I'm sure we would.
Right.
We're not Pokemon.
But she did say, she goes, "I don't recognize this person that you are now." I said, "That's good. Because I'm not the person that I was in high school."
Yeah.
It means that, and I'm not saying I'm better than you, but it means that I've evolved through mentally and spiritually to a certain level that you don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
Well, growth should be something you should be changing. You shouldn't be the same person you were 20 years ago, 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. You should be different, evolving, changing. Your experiences, your growth should happen over time. If it doesn't, right. Then, I mean, that's more of a telltale sign that something needs to happen.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I have a question, and it's, like, probably ungrowth of me, but, like, so there's, since there's 3 people, is that us 3, or are there 3 people watching?
It's the 3 of us.
Yeah.
With Luca.
It doesn't count.
Yeah, it doesn't count Luca because he's hosting.
Okay, cool. I saw somebody pop in on here, and if you're in here, I see you.
Yeah, the Momo lifter.
Yeah, I went out with him.
Oh. The thorn cut person is one of my friends from Oregon.
Okay.
He was texting me and I wasn't responding, so she probably went searching for me.
Okay.
That's what
I guess.
So, This is what I'd like to do. Mm-hmm. Ari, thank you so much for tonight. Seriously, that was awesome. I could see my roots coming out of my feet being sunk to the ground.
But and I talked to Grizz.
Right. I used to talk to Grizz about that, about the importance of grounding. Mm-hmm. Take your shoes off, get outside and through the ground, and stick your toes in the dirt. And stay there for a few minutes. But she lives in an area where everything is a cement. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And just the feeling of how I could feel energetically the my chakras being energized one by one by one by one by one by one. And in the middle of it is when it was right here, my heart chakra. Mm-hmm. I could feel that shit. And I know it hit because when I first started meditating 2 years ago or a year and a half ago, I could see all these different colors. The one color I would see all the time was yellow. I could see yellow and yellow and yellow. And it was just pulsing.
Solar plexus.
And I never saw that for a while, even at all these other times that I've been meditating. But I saw it again tonight.
Welcome.
That was so awesome. I'm glad we decided together and you chose to be that for us. Josh, I have a plan for you, Josh. We're going to talk about it.
Okay.
Because I was asked today, how did I decide how I would have Josh become a part of this group? I said, well, I know he's a part of this group, but a more active part. If it's something that you would consider doing and thinking about. I do have an idea.
I'm definitely looking to expand and rejoin people in a tribe. So I'm ready for it. I'm asking for it. I'm open to it.
You're definitely good.
That was Kyle too, by the way.
On the line.
Two people wet.
Sorry.
No, that's okay.
No.
What were you just talking about now?
I didn't hear either one.
What we're just talking about now is what Kelly was talking about with Kyle 2 tonight.
Okay. Yeah. No, Ari. Yes.
No, I just. Ari,
your turn.
Oh, I don't have anything to say.
So you guys can say, hey, Lucas, shut up. I'm trying to say something. All right? Or raise your hand. You're more than welcome to say that. We're not strangers anymore. We've been on live a few times, so he doesn't mean anything to say. He's looking to shut up. I got something to say. You won't hurt my feelings, trust
me. I don't have anything to say.
That's good. But thank you for doing that, Grizz.
Thank you.
Grizz.
Like, that was like, bullseye. Because you were cartoon. Or
Grizz?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, me too. Wait, was anyone pile one in this?
I was the first. I was like trying to like settle myself and getting a few things arranged, so I missed some of it. But I think it was pile one because she was talking about listen to your body.
Mm-hmm.
That was pile one, right?
Oh, she's so funny. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like I think I'm like it feels like you're reading it directly like to me like.
I remember that. Yeah.
What the heck? Hey, it's City.
Yeah.
But so I got a question.
Oh, no, me.
I'm pretty sure Josh will be here. Grizz, if you got something to do, it's okay. But we're going to do three plus me tomorrow. I have an idea. Oh, before I forget. Can I mention this real quick? I have a sponsor. Who contacted me and said, hey, I want to give you some prizes to give away for a contest. I'm like, all right, I don't have the contest. But.
Hi, Sergio.
I get a bunch of these.
Hi, Sergio. Bunch of these.
And what it is, it's a microfiber beach towel.
Oh.
And it's actually great. For washing clothes, not taking a bath. but I'll show you what it looks like. So I think I've got 5 to give away. Yeah.
Hmm.
You see it?
Nice.
Oh, the turtle.
So, 5 of these. So, I thought maybe we might do it tomorrow.
Okay,
cool.
I've got a couple of games we can do, or what do you suggest?
I was going to ask if you had games.
Girl, I'm the game master, if you don't know that.
I am the game master. Play tomorrow.
Yeah, come back tomorrow.
It's trivia.
I also have some shirts. But I couldn't find the shirts. I put it someplace, and I don't know where I put it. And I also have some shirts that have similar designs. But I've got 5 of these towels. I'd be willing to play for tomorrow. We can draw from the bag. I've got some trivia stuff here. I'll warn you, a lot of it might be a little bit more 18-plus.
My favorite kind.
So you might want to put the beds, the kids to bed, and turn the volume down just slightly.
It's midnight 30 when you start, so it's perfect for me.
Right, I know that. I know that. But I do have some games. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of talking. It's a lot of answers that I think you guys already know. A lot of it has to do with how dirty your mind is. Mine's just messed up, so I know all the answers. But half of the fun is seeing what you guys say.
Here's the thing. This is related, but about astrology. I swear it's kind of related. Kelly sent me, an astrology video. And I just can't pay attention to astrology because they keep saying something sextiling Uranus. And that's all I hear.
That's so funny. Yeah.
That was a running joke in Periscope.
Uranus. I don't know what that even means.
Well, let's just say
Uranus is conjunctivitis.
I mean, I know what I think it means, but I don't think it means that.
Let's just say when people make fun of it, it's not about the planet itself. It's about the part of the human body. It's a small the minds are sometimes, but these games are not like that. I mean, they sound like it should be something sexual, but when you hear the answer, it's not. And you freak yourself out like, man, okay, I get it. It's not all about sexual, not all about all these things, but it'll be fun. Man, the messages keep coming in, so... We'll do that tomorrow. I don't want to do questions tomorrow. Let's do trivia tomorrow. And we'll do 2 call-ins at a time.
Cool.
We'll choose numbers from 2 people calling at a time and play for it. And if you lose, you're out. We'll play King of the Hill. Next person up.
Nice.
All right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you guys for joining tonight. Thank you for... I had such a good time. I'm glad I did this. We're doing this. But yeah. We are doing
it. But
some good people, I think. Grace, thank you for all the hard work that you do every single time. And and Ari for being our moderator, support of you. We missed him day tonight, but I hope she's doing well. Mm-hmm. Josh, got big plans for you, my friend.
No.
All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good night. Bye. Love you guys.
Good night. Good night from Bowie.
Bye, Bowie.
Night.
Good night, buddy.